In this video, I'm going to be going over how to create a contact form in WordPress step by step. Creating a contact form in WordPress is a quick and easy process. By the end of this video, you will successfully have your contact form created and added on your WordPress website. Let's get started. To start, I'm here in the WordPress dashboard. Hover over the Plugins tab in the left side menu. Click Add New Plugin. In the search field, type in WPForms. Make sure it's all one word so that it pulls up easily. You'll see the WPForms plugin showing here. Click the Install Now button. Once it is done installing, click the Activate button. Once it is done activating the plugin, you'll be on the Welcome to WPForms page. Scroll down and click the Create Your First Form button. A pop-up will show saying, Welcome to the Form Builder. Click the Let's Go button. You'll see Name Your Form here, and put the form name you want to call your contact form here in the search box. I'll type in Contact Form for the name. Next, you'll see blank form here and a bunch of form templates showing here. If you scroll down, there's a ton of pre-made templates you can choose from based on your needs. I'll scroll back up to the top of the page. You'll see categories you can select over from the side to pull up templates based on that. If I hover over the simple contact form and click View Demo, I can then view what that contact form will look like, where I can begin working off of it. For this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a contact form from scratch. I'll hover over blank form and click the Create Blank Form button. It's now going to bring up the Contact Us page builder where we can create our contact form quick and easy. Now we want to add fields to our Contact Us form. I'll click Name to have the name field show. Next, I'll click Email to add an email field. Next, I'll add a paragraph text to the contact form. If you want to delete something from showing on the form, just hover over the field and click the trash can icon to remove that field. If you click the Duplicate Field icon, you can duplicate the field. If you want to move something to somewhere else on the form, just hover over it and drag it down or up to move it to somewhere else on the contact form. If you click something over from the side, you can drag it to where you want it in the form. To make edits to a form field section, click in the field. I've clicked in the name field. Under label, you'll see name. To change the name, you can replace what is there with whatever you'd like, and it'll change. Under format, click from the dropdown and you can select from simple, first last, first middle last. Simple will just show name and first middle last will show all three fields for the name. I'll select first last for mine. Where you see description, you can enter anything you'd like and it'll show up at the bottom of the field. You'll see required with the toggle at the bottom. You can toggle this off to make the field not a required field, or toggle it on to make it a required field. If you click Advanced, where you see Field Size, you can change the field size. Where you see Placeholder, if I enter your full name as an example, you'll see it shows in the text field. At the bottom, you'll see Hide Label. You can toggle this on if you want to hide the label of this field. I'll toggle it on and you'll see the eye icon with a line through it. Name won't show up in the contact form with this toggled on. I'll toggle it back to off. Where you see hide sublabels, if you toggle this on, it'll hide sublabels like the first and last name shown here in this field. I'll toggle it back to off. Next, click the Settings tab. You'll be in the General tab. Where you see Submit button text, you can change this if you'd like. Where you see Submit button processing text, you can change this to something else if you'd like. This will show up once someone clicks the Submit button on your form. If you click Notifications, this is where emails are sent when a form is submitted. You'll see Sent to Email Address. it'll by default have the email address used with your WordPress account. To change this, you can input the email you want for this. You can change the email subject line if you'd like. You can also change the form name and the from email address. Next, click Confirmations. Where you see Confirmation Type, you'll see Message is selected. This will show a confirmation message when someone fills out the form. You can change what the message says here. If you click Message under Confirmation Type, you can also select Show Page, and then you can select a page from your site that the site visitor is taken to once they submit the form. Under Confirmation Type, if I click Go to URL Redirect, you can put in a confirmation redirect URL they are taken to when someone submits the form. If you click Spam Protection and Security, there are spam protection and security options you can choose from or select. To save your changes, click the Save Changes button at the top right to save your changes for the contact form. I'll click the X button to exit out of the contact form builder. Now let's add the Contact Us form to a page in our WordPress website. I'll click Pages in the left side menu. Find the page you want to add to it and click Edit underneath. I'll click Edit under the contact page. Go to where you want to add it to the page and click the plus icon. In the search field, type in WPForms. Click WPForms. Click from the Select a Form dropdown. Select the form we just created with the name you gave it. The contact form has now been added to the page. Over to the right, you can choose to show or hide the title of the form by toggling it on or off. You can choose to show the description of the form by toggling it on or off. Scroll down, and under Field Styles, you'll see Size. You can change the size of the form. Border is where you can change the border of the contact form. You can change the border size and border radius. You'll see colors. You can change the background color. You can change the border color. You can change the text color. You can change the menu color. Under label styles, you can change the size of the labels. You can change the label color, sublabel and hint color, and error message color. Under button styles, you can change the size of the button, border, border size and border radius. You can change the background color of the button, border color of the button, and text color of the button. Click the Save Changes button at the top to save your changes. I'll click the View Page icon to bring up a view of the page. You'll see the contact form showing here. That's how to create a contact form in WordPress. Give this video a thumbs up and leave us a comment. Let us know if the tutorial was helpful or not, as the comments help improve our tutorials. Be sure to subscribe to our channel for more WordPress tutorial videos.